What's going on? Jun with the Sushi Man here, and today we're going to make some onigiri, also called omusubi, which are Japanese rice balls. And I'll show you three different types using some traditional but easy to get ingredients. They're extremely simple to make and delicious. Trust me, you will not regret learning how to make these. And if you stick to the end, I'll show you an onigiri hack that you won't want to miss. Alright, now let's jump right in. So very first, I want to clarify something really quick. A lot of people think onigiri is a type of sushi, but it is not. Onigiri is made using regular steamed rice, whereas sushi is made with vinegared sushi rice. And it's probably because onigiri is sometimes referred to as nigiri meshi, which sounds a lot like nigiri sushi, which is sushi. I know, confusing, right? Anyways, just wanted to bring that up since a lot of people get it confused. Alright, moving on to our tools and supplies. Now I'm not going to cover how to make rice in this video since I already have a detailed video that goes over that. Link over here if you want to check that out. So the tools and supplies that I have here are just the things we need to make the onigiri and some of the fillings. So I like to have a cutting board just to keep things nice and clean, but we won't be cutting anything. Just make sure you have a clean working surface or you can even use a plate. We're going to need a medium bowl, some plastic wrap, a shamoji, which is a rice paddle, or a spoon or a wooden spatula can work as well. Some foil to cook our salmon. Nonstick is preferable. A small bowl and a spoon to make our tunamayo, which you guessed it is tuna and mayo. And also for that we'll need some measuring spoons. This is a tablespoon and a teaspoon. A pair of chopsticks or a fork. A clean kitchen towel as always. And maybe a serving plate depending on how or when you're going to eat it. Now this last one, these are called onigiri molds. You can get these off Amazon for like 6-7 bucks, or I'm sure Asian markets have them too. You don't need it necessarily, but it does make things much easier, especially if you're planning on making onigiris often. Alright, on to our ingredients. First off, we're going to need rice, and this is steamed Japanese short grain rice. I personally like to use koshihikari, but there's a bunch of other great types out there. And this is a little over 3 standard US cups, which was 1.5 cups uncooked, or 2 rice cooker cups. Now, this is going to be a little bit more than what we need for our 3 onigiris, but you can always use it for something else, or you know what, just make more onigiris. And then we have our nori, which is dried seaweed, and these are half sheets. Some salt. Furikake, which is Japanese rice seasoning, and this is optional. This one is shiokombu, which is seasoned dried strips of kelp. It's another way to season the rice and again is optional. Now as I mentioned, I'm going to make 3 different types of filling for our onigiris. First one is sake or shake, both the same, which is salmon. And it doesn't really make sense to cook the amount for just one onigiri, so I have about a 1/2 pound fillet here, which I can use for more onigiris or chazuke or something. Next one is tunamayo. And what was that again? Just like how it kind of sounds, it's tuna and mayo. So we need some canned tuna, and this is about 3 ounces, drained. And some Japanese mayo, we have about 1 tablespoon. And then 1 teaspoon of ponzu. And you can use soy sauce if you like, but I prefer the ponzu because it has that citrus, which I feel goes well with the tuna. And then this last one is my personal favorite, umeboshi, which is pickled and fermented plum. So I have one of those here. And you should be able to find this at Asian markets. If not, I know Amazon sells some. Alright, that's about it. Let's get into preparing our fillings. So the first one we're going to prep is the salmon. And all we really need to do is cook it. And this is super easy. Just lay the fillet on a pan lined with foil, and then sprinkle some salt on it. Make sure to get both sides. And then we broil this in the oven on high for about 10 to 15 minutes. And of course the time will depend on how thick the fillet is, but basically you want it to be well done so it flakes off nice and easily. And if your salmon has a skin still on it, then broil it with the skin side up, and it'll get a nice crisp to it. Even though we won't use the skin for the onigiri, it can be a nice otsumami, or beer food. Now while the salmon cooks, let's make our tsunamayo mix. And this is another one that's extremely simple. Just add the 3 ingredients into the bowl and mix. And ta-da, done. All right, now the last one is the umeboshi. And this is probably the easiest out of all of them. All we have to do is remove the seed. However you want to do it. Cut it out, squeeze it out, surgically remove it. It's up to you. Don't worry, it's not rocket science. And I usually like to break this up just a little bit. You can use chopsticks or a fork and lightly smash it so that it breaks apart. Alright, the salmon is done now, and all we need to do from here is just break it apart into small flakes. So you can use chopsticks or a fork, and just check for any small bones while you're doing this. And since I'm not going to be using this whole thing, I'll stop right around there and save the rest. Alright, now we are ready to start making our onigiris. Alright, so the first one we're going to make is our salmon. And I'm going to add some furikake into the rice for this one. So let's add some rice into this bowl. And then we'll sprinkle some furikake in it. And then mix it in nice and even. Now we'll lay a sheet of plastic wrap on our board. And then scoop some rice onto the middle of it. Kind of spread it out evenly. And you don't need too much here. Depends on how big you want to make the onigiri, but I usually put about, what's that, like a drink coaster size or a small plate? Not sure really. Now we make a small pocket in the middle and then add our filling, which in this case is our salmon. Then we add a little more rice on top so it covers the salmon. And then from here, we take each corner of the plastic and bring it together. Then lift it up, and you kind of want to close the rice around the filling. Okay, then from here, we just shape it into a triangle with our hands. And this might take a little bit of practice. But what I do is, I kind of cup both hands, and then using this bend of your hand here, you want to gently press and give it that angle. And then rotate it, press, rotate it, press. And do that until it's shaped into a triangle, okay? So watch. Triangle, then rotate, press, rotate, press. And just keep doing it until, well, there you go. Congrats on making your first onigiri. That wasn't too bad, right? And trust me, this becomes easier and easier as you make more. So let's move on to our second one, which is the tunamayo. Now this is going to be pretty much the same. The only thing different that I'm going to do is keep the rice plain. Well, actually we'll just sprinkle a little bit of salt on there, but no furikake this time. Alright, so let's get the plastic wrap. And then this time we're going to use regular rice so we can go straight from here. Then now we're going to sprinkle a little bit of salt on here. Okay, now the small pocket in the middle. And then we'll spoon some of our filling, which is that tsunamayo. Add some rice back on top. Then a little pinch of salt again. And then close the plastic wrap and shape. Remember, rotate, press, rotate, press. And then boom. Easy as that. Alright, this last one I'm going to show you is the umeboshi. And this is actually my favorite combo because we're going to take some of this shiokombu and mix it into the rice. This adds that sweet, salty, umami flavor from the kelp and also gives it some nice texture. And also by changing the rice, it can differentiate the onigiris and you'll be able to tell what's inside each of them. As long as you're consistent with them, that is. Anyways, so same thing as when we did the furikake. Let's add some rice into our bowl. And then we'll toss some of this shiokombu in there. Mix it nice and even. And we're ready to go. Now it's the third time, so I'm sure you're getting used to this. But we'll start the same with the plastic. Put the rice down and spread it out. Pocket in the middle. And this time we'll put our umeboshi in there. And then add a little more rice on top. Close the wrap. And then rotate. Press, rotate, press. And voila! You see now how simple and convenient these are? What did that take us, like 5 minutes to make 3 of them? Now all we have to do is wrap it in nori and then eat it. And there are a bunch of different ways you can add nori onto here. You can use a small piece and leave most of the rice out, cut out little designs to make them all cute, or simply do what I do and wrap the entire thing. But I don't wrap it until I'm ready to eat, because seaweed gets soggy when it absorbs that moisture from the rice, and I prefer mine to be crisp. But let me show you how really quick. So these are half sheets of nori. And you can do this on your hand or a clean, dry surface. Just make sure it's nice and dry. So lay the nori with the rough side facing up, and then unwrap the onigiri. Maybe. There we go. And place it in the middle with the triangle pointing up. And then you simply fold in both sides of the nori, and then fold the edges in, and there you go. And I like to do it this way because you get a bit of nori with pretty much every bite. But again, you can use smaller sheets or cut these down to your liking. Or just eat it without it, it's totally up to you. But wait, what happened to that onigiri mold? Well, I did promise you an onigiri hack in the beginning of the video, and that is exactly what I'm going to show you now. With this. Making onigiri by hand is super easy, but this makes it 10 times easier. Let me show you. So it's a very similar concept. First, lay some plastic wrap over the mold and kind of push it in. Then we'll add some of our rice. And the key here is not to overpack it. Then a little bit of salt because we're using regular rice here. And then add whatever filling you're using. Top it off with some more rice and make sure it's spread across evenly. A little hint of salt again. Now we close the plastic wrap. And then all we do from here is use the press to squeeze it together. And look at that. Was that easier? I'm pretty sure it was. But either way, you're going to get some delicious onigiri that's super convenient for breakfast, on the go, lunch, picnics, even dinner. Nothing wrong with eating onigiris for dinner, by the way. Or how about a midnight snack? Now, quick question for you. Did you enjoy this video and the way I teach? And do you like sushi? If so, be sure to check out my book, How to Make Sushi at Home, a fundamental guide for beginners and beyond. It's my 20 plus years of sushi and Japanese cooking experience simplified into an easy to follow guidebook with step-by-step instructions and photos. Links are in the description for those that are interested. And now that you know how to make onigiri, try out some different fillings and see what you like best. And you may also want to pair it with some classic soul-warming miso soup. Lucky for you, I have a video just on that. Check it out with the link over here. Alright, thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe if you found it helpful. I'll see you on the next one. Arigatou gozaimasu.
Itadakimasu. Mmm. Mwah.